You're listening to PetLifeRadio.com.
I am Seth Peterson.
I am Debbie Hedren.
I'm Rhonda Schwartz.
I'm Doris Roberts.
This is Jesslyn Gilson.
Hello, I'm Victor West.
Hi, this is Charlotte Ross.
Hi, this is Ed Begley Jr.
What's up, you guys? This is AJ from the Backstreet Boys.
Hi, this is Shannon Elizabeth, and you're listening to Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets.
And you're listening to Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets.
With Jon Patch.
Jon Patch.
You're listening to Talkin Pets with Jon Patch.
Hello, America, and welcome to Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch. Join Jon and his expert guests with all of your pet questions, concerns, comments, and stories. Now it's time for Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch.
Welcome to Talkin' Pets, live from Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida, for Mardi Gras. This is Talkin' Pets, and I'm your host, Jon Patch. Joining us is animal expert
Barry Siebold.
Here to answer your medical questions and your behavior questions about your pets at 866-606-TALK. That's 866-606-8255. The show is produced by Mr. Bob Page. Hi, Bobby-o. It's his birthday today.
Happy birthday to
He's
you.
He's 14. I'm a little dyslexic, okay? Figure that out. The show is also produced by Mark at Business Talk and Lifestyle Talk Radio Network. So when you call in, you'll speak with Mark, and he'll throw you on the air with us. So if you've got a medical question or a behavior question, pick up the phone and give us a call because we want to talk about your pets. So we are open to your questions, your comments, and your stories at 866-606-TALK. That's 866-606-8255. We'll have trivia in this hour. If you answer it correctly, we're going to send out to you a bottle of Pettastic Naturals. That's 100% natural and made in the USA. And, by the way, it's earth-friendly. That's coming out to you, Pettastic.com. Also, Uncle Norman's Pet Bath Sponge. All self-contained. All you need is your pet and water. This is Talkin' Pets.
We'll be right back, right after these messages. Stay tuned.
Hey, ready to take a walk? Not just you, but the whole family. It's the 2009 Whisker Walk, Sunday, June 7th from 11 to 3 at the Lancaster Fairground in Lancaster, Massachusetts. Pet owners and animal lovers walk to lend a paw to benefit the animal shelters and pet charities they love. Come see exhibits, demonstrations, educational programs, special attractions, product giveaways, entertainment, auctions, raffles, food, fun, and things for adults and kids to see, do, and buy, both human and pet related. Whisker Walk 2009, a fun day for everyone. For more information, log on to whiskerwalk.org.
Want to know what cats like to eat for breakfast? Mice Krispies, of course. Learn everything there is to know about cats on Catitude with your host, Tom Doc. Each week, we'll spotlight a cool cat breed, give up-to-date advice on cat health, and check out spiffy new cat products. So curl up on the couch every week for a perfectly enjoyable time on Catitude. Every week on demand, only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
We welcome your calls and questions at 866-606-TALK. That's 866-606-8255. This is Kelly Clarkson's new single on her new CD, which is number one over the last 2 weeks.
I like it.
Original American Idol winner, Kelly Clarkson, who was just here at Mardi Gras at Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida, last week.
Packed the house here. Sounded incredible.
I hate you.
Just search YouTube. There's a bunch of videos people shot from here. It's pretty cool. Place. She said it was the loudest crowd she's ever played in front of.
I love Kelly Clarkson. I would have loved to have been here. What do I get? MC Hammer. No offense, MC, if you're listening, but because I think you're cool too, but I like me some Kelly Clarkson. 866-606-TALK, and if you're listening, Kelly, which you might be, I love you.
I think she got that the first, I don't know, six times you said it.
866-606-8255, that's the number to call with your pet questions. So, and by the way, you can go on to our webcam and watch us. Well, Bobby's working on it right now, and I don't even know if Mark can see me right now because he's not answering me either. But normally you can go onto our webcam and you can watch us on there live at TalkinPets.com as well as MySpace.com/TalkinPets. Click on the dog watching TV and you can watch us normally. And you can chat with us on there as well. But right now you can give us a call at 866-606-TALK. Bye, Kelly. Thank you, Kelly. We still love you.
You're welcome, John.
She sounded like that. She wouldn't be singing. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. We'll have trivia in this hour. Like I said, you can win some prizes, Pettastic, as well as, oh, there he is, as well as we are going to send out to you Uncle Norman's pet bath sponge. But,
Norman.
Thank you. That is a universal thing. Was that you? Or was that you?
That was me.
Oh, okay. I'm just totally confused.
See, I have little sound effects, too.
Okay. So, trivia questions. We will have trivia for you, but I want to know, Barry, you know I'm going to ask you a history trivia.
Yes, I know.
Stop peeking at my sheet.
I can't see it.
So, I want to know, I can't ask an animal because you know all the answers. The city of Los Angeles, L.A., yeah, L.A.
L.A., okay.
Was incorporated in what year? City of Los Angeles. I think it's like, what, the second biggest city in the country. Was incorporated in what year?
You really like to give me these, don't you?
You were, you know, take a stab.
1898.
Well, at least you were in the right century. It was 1850. But that's how it was played. Barry was wrong. Normally he'd get a bad voice, but he's not here with us right now.
The pet voice stepped out.
So that is incorrect, but I'll have a pet question for everybody out there. But happy birthday out there. Writer-producer David E. Kelly is 53. You know where he's from?
You know, I really wasn't even paying attention to him. Sorry.
Nice.
You are lower than... Never mind. Anyway, David E. Kelly.
Oh, okay.
Married to Michelle Pfeiffer.
Okay.
Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
Apparently not. Doogie Howser, Ally McBeal, Boston Legal. Great shows. So he created those. It's his birthday today. He's 53. He's actually younger than I thought he was. And actor Robert Iron Man Downey Jr. is 44.
Really? I thought he was older than that.
I thought he looks younger than that.
Yeah.
He looks
so do
good,
I.
Actually. You're 41.
Yeah, and I look all of 39 and a half.
Did you get us fixed over here?
I think we're good.
All right.
Well, hit refresh.
I will. That's on our webcam, so you can watch us live and you can actually communicate with us. Did you read what Mark said to you on there?
No.
So, okay. He's sitting there like glued to the screen now.
I will do that, sir.
Actress Nancy Jo from The Facts of Life McKeon is...
84 years old, I think.
She was kind of like the butch looking one, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the one with the dark hair. She's 43.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
I liked her, though.
Yeah, I did. She was... What was her character? Joe?
Joe.
She was the tough one.
Yeah, Nancy McKeon. Joe. J-O.
J-O.
No E.
No E.
She's actually 43 years old.
Didn't she have a motorcycle?
I think so.
You take the back, you take the bottom, there you have the facts of life.
I used to love this show.
The facts of life. There's a time you got to go and show you're growing, now you know about the facts of life. The facts of life. When the world never sees.
I heard they made a Naughty Facts of Life now, too.
Really?
Yeah, it was all over the media.
Like a television or just a movie?
No, it's like, I think it's a series.
But nice!
But it's nasty.
I'm going to the internet right now.
Not rated G, put it that way. But anyway, pick up the phone, give us a call, 866-606-TALK. We're going to go to your calls in a second. If you're going to the movies this weekend, top five movies as of last week, Monsters vs. Aliens was number one, made $59 million. The Haunting in Connecticut, $23 million made. And I'll tell you right now, if you want a great scary movie, The Haunting in Connecticut is what to see because it really is a great movie. It's not like your slasher kind of thing where somebody gets an axe through their head. It's really, truly a scary, scary film. And it's probably one of the best ones I've seen in a long time. Number three was Knowing. Skip that one. Number four, I Love You, Man. And that was actually funny. And number five was Duplicity. Didn't see that. But I did screen Fast and the Furious. And if you want to read my review, you can go to TalkinPets.com. or myspace.com/talkingpets. Click on movie reviews and you can read about The Fast and the Furious. It was actually a decent movie. Not totally recommendable, but it was good. It's nice to see Paul Walker and Vin Diesel back together again. 866-606-TALK. First trivia question we're going to put out there. I didn't even ask a trivia question. I think people are calling for trivia.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
That is kind of neat, actually. So I think it's for trivia, according to what Mark's saying. All right. Well, here's the trivia question. Pekingese dogs were sacred to the emperors of China for more than how many years? They are one of the oldest breeds of dogs in the world. Pekingese dogs were the sacred to the emperors of China for how many years? More than how many years? They are one of the oldest breeds of dogs in the world. Now, I got to give you the years because you'll never get it. We'll be here all year if you had a guess on that. So it's either 2,000 years, for more than 2,000 years, for more than 5,000 years, or for more than 10,000 years. Pekingese dogs, China. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. Lee out in Yorktown. Hey, Lee, what do you think? You want to take a stab at that trivia?
Well, not that one. No, the only one I knew is when Los Angeles was incorporated.
Oh, that was one for Barry. He answered that one already.
Well, I didn't realize that. Well,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, but you know what? What year do you think it was?
Well, 1850.
All right. You know what? I'm gonna since you
okay, terrific.
Since you weren't paying attention, but I'm gonna give you half a prize. I'm gonna give you a bottle of Pettastic Naturals. We're gonna ship that out to you.
Oh man, that'd be great.
It's great stuff too, Lee. So stay on the line, and what we'll do is we'll ship that out to you. We'll get your address. Mark will talk to you, and we'll ship that right out to you in Yorktown, Indiana.
Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome, Lee. That's Lee out there. Nice that he was paying attention.
All right, it happens.
You
to
did
me
give
the
answer, right?
Yeah.
Or I actually gave the answer.
You gave
you
it.
Were wrong.
I was wrong.
You said 1890-something.
1898, I think.
Yeah, it was 1850.
I'm always wrong.
But, you know, Lee knew, even without paying attention. Like you, when you were looking at the TV and you weren't paying attention when I was talking to you.
Uh-huh.
I get that a lot. 866-606-TALK. 866-606-8255. Well, the animal trivia is out there, the pet trivia. Pekingese dogs were sacred to the emperors of China for more than how many years? They're one of the oldest breeds of dogs in the world. Was it 2,000, 5,000, or more than 10,000 years? 866-606-TALK. What is it with China? China, all of a sudden, you know, they were to blame for all the deaths of all the dogs here and the pets here in this country when the tainted food pet recall came out, where the guy that actually made that happen killed himself. And then now there's a drywall. You heard about that?
Yeah.
Tainted drywall
tainted.
From
What's
China.
What's it tainted with, though?
I don't know, but it's like, you know, people are getting sick and stuff from drywall.
Yeah.
Is everything coming out of China now tainted? Is that their way of getting back at us? You know, it's a conspiracy.
Something's going on.
Now you better watch out for these Pekingese dogs. You never know. They were sacred to the emperors of China.
Tainted Pekingese?
Might be biters. Give us a call. Was it 2,000, more than 5,000, or more than 10,000 years? Pekingese dogs were sacred to the emperors of China for how many years? More than 2,000, more than 5,000, or more than 10,000 years? Bottle of Pettastic Naturals, and also Uncle Norman's Pet Bath Sponge is yours. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Barry Seawolf.
866-606-TALK. This is Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets. We'll be right back after a short pause. Well, four to be exact.
Yeah. Greetings, human. What planet am I on?
Welcome to Pet Planet. Here's a copy of Pet Planet magazine, Florida's most informative and fun pet resource magazine. It features heartwarming stories and informative articles from local and national pet experts.
Excellent.
Pet Planet magazine offers Operation Planet Rescue, helping rescued pets find new homes. And it's available at 500 locations in South and Central Florida and 24/7 on the internet at PetPlanetMagazine.com. If you're out and about with your pet, you may be featured in paparazzi, candid pictures of you and your pet. For up-to-date pet-friendly events, activities, and pet-related services and products, Pet Planet Magazine is your final destination.
I shall take this magazine home with me.
Back to your home planet?
No. To my condo in Boca.
Pet Planet Magazine. Check them out at www.petplanetmagazine.com or 352-394-8578. It's out of this world.
Coast to coast and around the world, it's All Behave with Arden Moore. Find out why cats and dogs do the things they do and get the latest buzz from wagging tongues and tails in Rin Tin Tinseltown. From famous pet experts and best-selling authors to television and movie stars, you'll get great tail-wagging pet tips and have a fur-flying fun time. All Behave with America's pet edutainer, Arden Moore. Every week on demand, this is the place for a special paparazzi treat. Only on PetLifeRadio.com. Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
Again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
Pick up the phone, give us a call, 866-606-TALK. One of the first sentimental stories from Mr. Bob Page in about 10 years.
He must be getting soft in his...
But he won't play my poetry in the bottom of the arm, but he'll do that one. That was a good story, though. But you know what? It's, you know, that same thing, though. We had a woman that called up here and needed surgery for her pet. And I figured what part of the country she was in. And she couldn't afford it. And the most amazing thing happened. One of our callers from another part of the country called up and offered to pay for it and did.
Wow.
I mean, it wasn't one of those like, I'll pay for it, and then they never did. She did. That's amazing.
It's so things like that, it gives
hope that there's actually people out there like that, you know? Yeah, I know, mine too. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. Pick up the phone, give us a call. We want to talk to you about your pets. 866-606-8255. The lines are open. We're going to go out real quick to, we got holding on out there, Leo, and Leo's in Hamden, Indiana. He thinks he has a stab at the trivia question. Leo, we want to know, Pekingese dogs were sacred to the emperors of China for more than how many years?
Well, 2000? I'm going to take, I don't think it's been way up in the 10,000, so I'll go along with 2,000 years.
You think 2,000 years?
That's my guess.
Exactly!
That's it, exactly, 2,000 years. Wow, Bobby, you're going to blow my eardrums out. That is right. You know, it was 2,000 years, and what we're going to do is we're going to send out to you a bottle of Pet-tastic Naturals. It's 100% natural. It's guaranteed to take out anything. And we're also going to send out to you Uncle Norman's Pet Bath Sponge so you can bathe your Pekingese.
All right.
Well, stay on the line there, Mr. Excited, and we're going to send that out to you, Leo, in Hamden, Indiana. So stay on the line, speak with Mark. We'll get your address and ship that stuff right out to you.
Okay.
And call again. Spread the word. We want to hear from your friends. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. That's the number to call. Barry, real quick, you can go on to our webcam. You can watch us live right now here at Universal on the webcam. And you can also chat with us on the web chat as well at TalkinPets.com or MySpace.com/TalkinPets. Click on the dog watching TV and you can watch us and chat. But we have Skibby. That's his name, or her name. Skibby. Skibby wants to know, she has a 1-year-old cat, 1 year, 2 months, and she had it declawed.
Okay.
And she put newspaper in a litter box, which is what you're supposed to do, right?
Right.
For the first how many days?
At least 10 to 14 days, depends on if they use glue or sutures.
But Skibby's kitty now is sleeping in a litter box with the newspaper.
Cats love newspaper. There is actually newspaper. You could probably get it at your local pet store that is compressed down and it looks like cat litter. The whole purpose is the clay cat litter will stick, or sand will stick to the declaw site and can cause infection. So that's why you want to use the newspaper so nothing will stick to it. My cats did the same thing and I had to go and get the compressed. I forget what it's called off the top of my head. But
if you go to your local pet store, they'll know what it is.
It looks like little pellets, but they're actually made out of newspaper.
Oh, I know what you mean. I know what you mean. I've seen those. Okay.
It says like recycled newspaper or something like that on it.
So, Skibby, check that out. Hopefully you're listening to us right now, and if you're not, you can listen to us on the net as well. But, Skibby, look for that compressed paper at your local pet store. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
You're listening to Talkin' Pets, 866-606-TALK. Pick up the phone, give us a call. We want to talk about your pets.
We seldom think of death until it occurs. It seems to be in our distant futures. We associate it with getting old. At least that was the belief, as we've been told. But death sees no face, age, race, species, or personality. It does not matter if you live amongst rich, middle class, or poverty. However time decides it is your turn, we can only watch the ones that have gone before us and learn. It is my time to say goodbye to my master who shall watch me die. I am young and life was short for me, but I will live forever in my master's memory. The hardest part of dying is to leave my master and friends, but who is to say that this life is the end? for since I must leave this life not of choice, I pray that someday again I will hear my master's voice. There is so much I want it to do and be, but life is over, at least for me. My only wish is that my master I leave behind will always remember me and a smile shine. Although at times life has been hard and difficult, I know now that the reasons were not all my fault. You take life's punches as they come, many at a time, or one by one. I lived my life as best I could, and answered the questions I thought I should. But death is a challenge that no one will conquer. Whether young, old, one or 100, no one shall live forever, I'm sure. And if you'd like to get a copy of that poem, I wrote that, you can just send me a self-addressed stamped envelope to Jon Patch at P.O. Box 262526, Tampa, Florida, 33685, and I'll be glad to send that out to you. But, Barry, that's one thing, is that a lot of, you know, the perception is a lot of people think they live forever, but they don't look at life. And the same thing with our pets. I mean, when you go to live your life with a cat or a dog, the life expectancy of a dog is anywhere between 10 and 15 years, basically. And a cat, what, 15 to maybe 20 years?
Could be, yeah.
So you have to go in knowing that, just like with people, we all have our time that we pass on. Once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. Give us a call at 866-606-TALK. 866-606-8255.
You're nobody till somebody loves you. You're nobody till somebody cares. You may be king, you may possess the world and its gold, but gold won't bring you happiness when you're growing old. The world still is the same, you never change it. As sure as the stars shine above, you're nobody till somebody loves you.
Karaoke night.
So I already have to deal with that enough, thank you.
Yeah, you do, don't you?
Yeah.
866-606-TALK. These kids are throwing balls at us.
I know. I saw
that. We're here live at Universal. Keep your balls to yourself.
You know they have karaoke out here at City Walk? With a full live band behind you.
Really?
That could be cool.
Backup singers, the whole deal.
Should I do it? Should I do it?
Yeah, I hope so. Catch a rising star.
Right.
City Walk.
That would
UniversalOrlando.com.
This place, if you guys have been to Universal, you've got to schedule a vacation to come down here. Wave to Bob in the window.
There's hotels here, too. You can stay right here on the property, which is cool. So you don't have to ever leave.
And what's awesome, if you stay on property and you stay in one of the three beautiful Lowe's Resort hotels, your room key becomes a front-of-the-line pass.
Awesome.
You don't wait in line.
That's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
I'm not promoting this because I get paid for it, because I don't. It's really a cool place here. And you really got to check it out. It's a lot of fun. I love Universal.
I know.
My favorite ride is at Escape over there, and it is Spider-Man.
Oh, I love Spider-Man.
When he jumps on your car.
And the Hulk. I like the Hulk roller coaster.
I don't do well with roller coasters since I had a heart attack. I can't go on them anymore.
Yeah,
and now that I had open heart surgery a couple weeks ago, I cannot go on.
You shouldn't even walk by them.
I know. No more rides for me, apparently. Such a boring life. 866-606-TALK. 866-606-8255. Pick up the phone. I'm spitting. 866-606-8255. Pick up the phone. Give us a call. We want to talk to you, of course, about your pets. You know, I talked about movies, you know, real quick on this thing. And, you know, at the top of the hour and what movies to go see. But 20th Century Fox... I told them I would do this and promote this, which I think is pretty cool. Hugh Jackman challenges X-Men fans across the country to be the first to witness the origins by winning the world premiere of X-Men Origins Wolverine for their hometown.
Now, in an announcement made on YouTube, Hugh Jackman, who plays the famed anti-hero in X-Men Origins Wolverine, is taking Hollywood and the film's premiere to the people who made the X-Men film series one of the industry's biggest, inviting the Legends of X-Men fans across the United States to be the first to witness the origins in their hometown with the cast on Monday, April 27th. Now, to put a bid in to host the premiere, fans need only to remember that X marks the spot at the website. They should mark their town with a digital X. The location with the most votes, X's that is, will win the red carpet star-studded movie premiere. The winning town will be announced on April 20th. The website, www.x-menorigins.com/premiere. Click on that. X your town, and you could actually have the premiere with Hugh Jackman and the whole gang in your town. So check it out. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. Pick up the phone, give us a call. We want to talk about your pets, of course. We're open to your medical questions and your behavior questions. 866-606-8255. As we go out to the break, here's your next trivia question. You get this right, we're going to send you out a bottle of Pet-tastic Naturals. For Stephen King's movie, this movie came out in 1983. It starred five St. Bernards that were used, one mechanical head, and an actor in a dog costume to play the title character. What movie was this by Stephen King? 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. You know what movie we're talking about? Pet-tastic Naturals is yours. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
Live from Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida, for Mardi Gras, this is Talkin' Pets. Is that King Kong?
Talkin' Pets. We'll be right back after a short pause. Well, four to be exact.
Pet Life Radio presents Paranormal Pets, where you can always expect the unexpected. Each week, we'll discuss all aspects of weird or spiritual animal encounters, ghosts, totems, psychic animals, animal souls, animal angels, and animals in religion, with a little cryptozoology thrown in. Step into the supernatural world of pets with your Paranormal Pets ghostly host, Dusty Rainbolt, every week on demand, only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
We welcome your calls and questions at 866-606-TALK. Like I said, you can check us out on the webcam, watch us live here at Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida for Mardi Gras by going onto our website, TalkinPets.com, or MySpace.com/TalkinPets. Click on the dog watching TV and you can watch us. And you can even chat, too. There's a lot of chatting going on right now. Susan, Mom, Three Boys, and Skibby are having a great conversation amongst each other, which is cool. So, and I want to talk about that in just a second. But we have Leslie holding on in Portland, Oregon on KBNP. And I gave her a trivia question. You must have Googled it by now, Leslie.
I'm at the dog park. I can't.
Oh. Well, you know, they have technology now.
Yeah. I'm going to give a rough guess of, like, maybe three.
You think three? President Franklin D. Roosevelt's most famous canine companion was his Scottish Terrier, Fala, who was part of the Roosevelt Memorial in Washington, D.C. But during Roosevelt's 12 years and 1 month as president, how many dogs lived in the White House? Now, I'm going to give you two guesses because we're at the top of the hour. And your first guess is three. I will say that you were incorrect. And
okay.
I will tell you, though, Leslie, in Portland, Oregon, it is higher.
Than five? I'm trying to figure out, in 12 years, how many dogs their life expectancy, so.
But he loved dogs.
I'm sorry?
He loved dogs.
He loved dogs. Okay, let's go seven.
You think seven?
I have no idea.
You get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir.
Madam. And sorry, Leslie, I would love to say you're a winner, but you're not.
That's okay. How many did he have?
I can't tell you because I'm gonna throw it out for one more person, but keep listening and we'll tell you then.
Okay.
You stink and I don't like you.
That was nice.
That was a bad one.
Enjoy the dog park, Leslie. Somebody's got a minute to answer the question. 866-606-TALK. Sorry. 866-606-8255. Bobby, my producer's yelling at me. I'm getting too close to the mic. I'm used to like talking up to the mic.
I know. These are, you know, Neumanns. You got to back off.
Okay. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. Somebody knows how many dogs Roosevelt had in his 12 years as president. And don't forget the 1 month. It's not three, it's not five, it's not seven, but it is higher. 866-606-TALK. You got about 30 seconds. Call right now, and Mark will throw you on the line with this, and you could be a winner of Pettastic Naturals. Poor Leslie was not. I wanted her to be a winner.
I know.
Now listen, the music's starting. Somebody's got to know. Mark, anybody out there? Anybody want to take a guess? It's higher than seven. What? We got Pete in Sholo, Arizona. What do you think, Pete? How many dogs?
11.
Congratulations.
Hello, exactly.
That was good. Congratulations,
good.
Pete. That is absolutely correct. He actually included a bull mastiff, two red setters, a retriever, a bulldog, another setter, a Scotch Terrier, a Great Dane, a sheepdog, a German Shepherd, who tried to rip the pants off the British Prime Minister. congratulations. We're going to send you out a bottle of Pettastic Naturals. Stay in line, speak with Mark. Spay and neuter your pets. Help control that pet population. Live from Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida, I'm Jon Patch.
Barry Siebold.
I'm Ben Franklin.
Thanks for tuning in to Talkin' Pets.
Let's Talk Pets. Every week on demand. Only on PetLifeRadio.com.